friends, welcome to Learn with Lucky's channel. I am Devanshi from year 5 and I am studying Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Today in this video I am going to tell you about a story called The Lazy Sun. So let's start our story. Once upon a time there was a rich man who was called the money lender because he was very kind to people and he would always share his money to everyone. He has a wife and a son. The son's name was called Sunny. Sunny was very lazy and always laid in the bed sleeping. He never woke up at least 1 hour or a few minutes. The whole day he just slept in the bed and did nothing. He was just pretending to sleep so that his mother and father does not even give him any work. But unfortunately, one day the Sunny's father asked Sunny, "Sunny, my dear boy, wake up. We need to go to the Shiva temple and then continue on our business. Please, wake up, wake up. Come on, hurry up, the time is almost up," said the father, yelling and yelling. But Sunny was just pretending to be asleep. He did not even answer a reply. And after 1 hour only, he replied. So Sunny said, "Father, don't wake me up. I'm so sleepy. Please go away. You do your own business. I don't know all of those. Please go away. I'm very sleepy." He said like that and then he fell asleep again. Sunny's father was very upset of him and he thought, "Oh my dear boy Sunny, how is he ever going to grow up like this? Oh God, it's all for yours. Please make my son better." So Sunny's father prayed and prayed like that. And then the next day, same thing happened. And the father went to the Shiva temple, prayed over there about Sunny, and then went back to continue his business. So unfortunately for the whole family, the business was becoming less and less because of Sunny. Sunny did not know this. He was just sleeping again. He did not even wake up. So one day, due to this, Sunny's father was very upset and very, very upset, and so he died. Sunny's father died. Sunny did not even wake up at that time. The mother yelled, "Sunny, wake up! Your father died. We need to find a solution how to discuss this problem. Come on, go to the business shop and work over there, Sunny. Get up." So Sunny's mother yelled and yelled. And then Sunny said, "Okay, fine, I woke up. But how? I don't even know about business. Teach me a little thing and I will go business on myself. And we will become rich again," said Sunny proudly. And then the Sunny's mother said, "Oh Sunny, my dear Sunny, your grandfather lives in the next village. Go and ask him the business properties and he will help you so much." And then Sunny went again to sleep and then said, "Okay mother, I will go tomorrow. Not today, it's already night." And then Sunny's mother said, "Yes, yes, eat your dinner and sleep. Don't just sleep like that." And then Sunny said, "Oh yes, I forgot. Give me my dinner and I'll go to sleep. I am very sleepy already now. Please pass," he said and said. So after eating, Sunny fell asleep. So as his mother. So the next day, Sunny set out to his grandpa's village. So he was riding and riding on his bicycle. At last, after 3 hours, he reaches grandpa's village. And Sunny went to grandpa's home and said, "Oh grandpa, you must help me. Please help me. My father died. Since my father died, my mother is always scolding me that go for business, work and work. We are not becoming that rich and the business has become very less. Please help us. Please tell me a solution and I will do it." And then Sunny's grandfather thought for a while. And then he did not say to Sunny. So he thought to himself, "If I make Sunny go out of this laziness, Then maybe they will become rich again, said Sunny's grandfather. And Sunny's grandfather was really overjoyed and then said to Sunny, Oh my dear boy Sunny, there is nothing I need to help you. You must help yourself, said Sunny's grandfather. But Sunny did not even understand what his grandfather was saying. So he asked, Grandfather, what are you saying? You need to help me. Please, what can I do myself? And then Sunny's grandfather said, Oh my dear Sunny, you must do all the work on yourself. Get out of your laziness, wake up early morning and go to the Shiva temple and pray for a while, at least 1 hour, and then go back to your business. So that is how you do it, and then you will become rich. I don't need to even help you. You need to help yourself. Oh, okay, I will do it for tomorrow, said Sunny like that. So he went back home. He was riding on his bicycle. So he went home and then told his mother everything. Mother, Grandpa said that I need to wake up early morning, get off my laziness and brush my teeth and then go to the Shiva temple and pray over there and then go back to business, said like that grandfather. And then Sunny said, Grandfather said to do us like that and then we will become rich. And then Sunny's mother said, Yes, Sunny, you really need to do that. Good job. Wake up early in the morning and get off your laziness. Do, go. I don't care. So they fell asleep that night. And then after Sunny woke up early in the morning, he took away his laziness. And then he went to the Shiva temple and prayed over there. Oh my God, please make my business very well. Please. So he prayed like that. And then he went to the business shop. So after going for a few days continued like this, one people on his shop or business said, our boss is every day coming to business. How is this possible? And then another person said, or we can also call it another labor, said that, yes, it is very strange. Sunny's father died and now Sunny is coming. But everyone in the village says Sunny is very lazy. And then Sunny replied to all of them, I am not lazy from now on. I am coming every day. So all the persons and all the people in the village became very scared and never talked about their father or also Sunny. So that day, Sunny went back home as usual, they had dinner and fell asleep as usual. So the next morning, Sunny went and do his brush and then go to the Shiva temple and prayed the same thing he had prayed yesterday and then went back to his business shop. And then the business people said, Oh Sunny, I am really sorry for what I have today. Please, I'm really sorry for what I have done yesterday. Please forgive me. Sunny thought to himself, maybe I can forgive her. So yes, I will forgive you. From now on, let's continue with our business and love with people, said Sunny. All the laborers and all the people in the village, especially the grandfather and the mother, were really shocked. Oh my God, Sunny, my dear boy, he's very kind and generous now. So after doing this for days and days, they became rich again. And then Sunny's mother said, Oh my dear Sunny, my boy, go to your grandfather and say, Thank you, grandfather, because he helped us a lot. And he will tell you a few sentences, said Sunny's mother like that. And then Sunny did not know what are the few sentences. So he just rode on his bike and then went to Grandpa's house or also in the village and then only went to his house. And then he thanked Grandpa. Oh, Grandpa, I really, really appreciate you. Thank you so much. You helped us a lot. I really, please, if I have to do anything, tell me right away. I will do it. And then Sunny's grandfather said, Sunny, I did not help you. You helped yourself, said Sunny's grandfather with joy. But Sunny was very confused. What? I helped myself, grandfather, but you gave me the idea. And then Sunny's grandfather laughed and laughed and smiled. Sunny, let me tell you a few sentences. And then Sunny thought, oh yeah, this was a sentence that mother took. So he sat and then listened to his grandpa's words. Oh my dear Sunny boy, I asked you to do this because you were so lazy and always sleeping in your bed. So you must get out of your laziness and go work in the business shop, said Sunny's grandfather like that. And then Sunny realized his mistake. Oh, I am really sorry, my dad and my grandfather and the whole family. Please forgive me. Please, I appreciate for what you have done. From now on, I won't be lazy at all. From this day, Sunny was very kind and generous. He lived his whole life like that. So, the moral of the story is, get out of your laziness and work somehow. Laziness is a very bad thing. Bye friends. Today's video is finished. See you in the next video. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And also click on the bell notification. Bye bye.